everyone, and a very warm welcome to WsCube Tech. So guys, in our previous session, we have covered that how we can extract the data from a table, and we have also covered the header part. In our today's session, we will be learning how to extract the rows, that means the remaining data from our table. To obtain the remaining data, let's have a look on our website, and then we will be obtaining the rest of the data. So guys, we are back to our website where we were extracting the data. We have already extracted the headers. Now all we need to do is extract these table data. So these table data over here are here in our table rows. All I need to do is, you can see over here we have TR. TR is what? A table row. And as soon as I open it, we have some table data thing. In table data, we have different things. For example, we have Indian hotel. Another table data says the number, that is the price, that is 315.35. Another table data says the 349, that is the high price. Okay, so this is how we can view the table data. Now, we need to first create a loop which will find us all the TR tags, and then another loop that will find us all the TD tags. So for that, what we will be doing, let's come back to our program. And as of now, we have the column headers. So let's put this inside the comment. Now we need to obtain all the TR tags because all our data is in our rows. So we need to obtain TR tags. For TR tags, we will be writing rows is equals to soup, or we can go for table, that table dot find all, and we need to find all the TR tags here. And I'll be writing TR inside it, and let's print rows, and let's have a look on what output we will get as well. So as soon as I run it, you can see over here that I have again received this company, this price and day high, because what is happening over here, that everything is there in the TR tag, let it be the table head or table data, everything is there in the TR tag. So what we need to do, as you can see over here, we are getting these things inside a list. So we need to skip this part. To skip this part, what we will do, we can write over here that for I in rows, and because we are iterating over here, we will be starting our iteration from index 1 and it goes up to the end. We will be skipping the part which is on index number 0. Why we are skipping it? Because we have already obtained it over here in our TH tag, that is table head tag. Okay, so from starting, and then we can directly print I here. So let's see how does it looks like now. So now you can see it is starting from Indian hotel, and the prices, it's not starting from where it was starting before. Okay, now we do not have to obtain this. What we need to obtain is the text from here. So if I write I dot text, let's see what output we'll get. So now I'm getting the output as well, which is like this, but it is what it is in the format of. So now I'm getting the output like this. Now what do I need to do? I need to obtain this in the format of a list as the table heads here, right? So what I'll do, I'll obtain them in a different way. Like for example, here I'll be writing table dot find all, and we will be looking for our TD tags, that is the table data tags, and let's store it inside something. So let's call it data only. Data is equal to table dot find all table data, and we will be printing this data only. Now as soon as I run it, we have received all our TD tags over here. Okay, once we have received all our TD tags here, I hope this is starting from, yes, it's starting from Indian hotel. Now we need to put it inside a list. So let's create a list here. Now that we have received the data in this format, all we need to do is put it inside a data frame and by obtaining the text from here. So for obtaining the text from here, we know that it's a row data. So I'll be writing row is equals to, here I'll be using the method of list comprehension, that let's say it's a table row text, right? So I'll be writing tr dot text, that is what we need to obtain for tr in our rows, or actually data. And lastly, what do we need to do? We need to add this data to our data frame. Let me just remove this thing and let's print the row for you. I'll just print the row for you so that you can see how does the data looks like. So as soon as I run it, this is how our data looks like. Now all we need to do is, okay, it's getting printed again and again. So it should be coming only one time. For some reason, it's getting printed again and again. Let's just find it one time. Instead of using find all, we will just use find. It will only give us the first data. Find all. Use karna hai. So over here, you will notice that it is getting printed again and again. And the reason why it is getting printed again and again is this. That here we need to write i.findAll because we are iterating in this loop. So now if I run it. Okay. So we have got the data like how we wanted it. We have Indian hotel whose price is this and high price is this. Then we have another one, Adani Enterprises, whose price is 4008.85 and high price is 4048.95. Okay. Now we have got this data. All we need to do is we need to append it to our data frame. For appending it to our data frame, we will be finding its length. So length is equal, L is equals to length of data frame. And at the location of this data frame, so df dot location of L, what we will do, we will add a row and the location of L should be there in our square bracket. So every time, whatever the length will be, so initially the length would be 1. So on index 1, this row will be added. Then again, this loop will execute and now the length of the data frame will be 2. And then on index 2, this new row will be added. So this is how it will happen. And lastly, let's print our data frame. So print data frame and I'll just remove all the print statements from here. So directly we'll get the data frame only as soon as I run it. So here you can see we have received our data frame which says company price is rupees this, day high rupees is this. Here also you will notice that we have backslashes and n. We can also remove these backslashes and n very simply. All you need to do is use your strip method. And by using the strip method, we can easily remove these backslashes and n. So I hope you guys have no doubts and no question on how we have created this table. Now if you want, you can directly save it to your CSV file as well by writing df.toCSV. That means we need to save it in a CSV file. You can give it any name over here. For example, this is our stock market data. So _market_data and remember to add the extension .csv. Once we are done with this and once we again run this program, this will be added to a CSV file. And I hope you guys have no doubts and no questions on how we have done it. So initially we have started by using the request module and importing pandas and using BS4, that means beautiful soup. After that, using the request module, we have obtained the HTML. Once we have obtained the HTML, we have looked for the table data. Once we have found the table data, the first thing that we need to do over here is find the table headers. For finding the table headers, we need to look for the TH, that means table head tag. Similarly, if you want to find the table row, that means TR tag, you will find everything if you click on the navigation bar. And you do not need to remember these things as well for like the HTML part. The other part, yes, you definitely need to remember. But these are, I guess, very easy to understand that TH stands for table head, TR stands for table row, and TD stands for table data. That inside every row, we have a table data and we have to iterate inside it to obtain all of them. Lastly, we have created a data frame and we have also added to a CSV file. So I hope guys that you have no doubts and no questions. In our next session, we are going to work on a mini project where we will be extracting data from an IPL website. In our next session, we are going to create a mini project where we will be extracting a table data from an IPL auction website. So stay connected guys and I'll see you in the next session. Thank you.